Hey guys, I'm Patrick with Frame.io, and today we're going to be talking about working remotely with Adobe Premiere Pro and Frame.io. Now, if you're working with a remote editor, then you need to, first of all, get footage to them. With our Adobe Premiere Pro panel, you have the ability to upload any file from your desktop or from an external drive or maybe from a connected server, or you have the ability to upload an entire bin from Premiere. This comes in really handy if maybe you've got a bin full of sound effects or stock footage, or maybe you've already organized your footage into bins. Additionally, if you've got organization that you want your editor on the other end to have access to, you can, in fact, upload your entire Premiere Pro project through the Premiere panel. On the other side, the editor has the ability to download that Premiere Pro project, and they can download either the camera originals, or they can download any number of different types of proxies. Now, if they're downloading in a batch, they only have the ability to download the highest resolution proxies or the lowest resolution proxies. Highest resolution is great when you're on a pretty decent internet connection, but maybe you're on hotel Wi-Fi and you need to be able to download all of these files. What are you gonna do? Well, you're gonna download at the lowest resolution possible. However, whenever you find a better internet connection and you're ready to upgrade your proxies from the lowest resolution to the highest resolution, then you can, in fact, reinitiate that download once you're on higher speed internet, and it will automatically replace those files so you don't have to do any relinking on your end. Once the edited sequence is complete, you have the ability to upload your active sequence to Frame.io for review. Once you have your notes, you can open up the Frame.io panel in Premiere, and you can link your timeline to the Frame.io panel. This gives you the ability to go note by note and make changes in your timeline without having to guess where that time-coded note is. You can also download each and every one of the comments into your timeline as a marker inside of Premiere Pro. So when it comes to working with Frame.io inside of Adobe Premiere Pro, you have the ability to upload files, download files in their original format or in some sort of proxy variant, and you have the ability to collaborate on your actual projects themselves. This makes working with remote editors significantly easier.